How's it going, guys? I am Dalton Cross. If you are new to the video, I make tons of great content on my channel, mostly around FPS games and stuff. But today for this video, we're going to be doing a Q&A. I put a tweet out on my Twitter that I wanted to do a Q&A video and to get a couple of questions ready for anybody who would like any questions answered to them for the video. If you guys want to follow my Twitter, it's going to be at Dalton Cross with three S's instead of two. I'll drop the link in the description for any other of my socials and my Twitter. But yeah, if you guys want to be in my next Q&A video, I'll also do some Q&A questions in this video's comment section if anybody decides to leave some at all. And so we'll get to the very first question, which comes from PokemonLover9000. This question reads, tell us your journey through competitive gaming, Twitch upstart, and inspirations, and where do you hope to take this into the future? First off, this is a really good question. So as I started playing very competitively in Call of Duty competitive, which was around like 2013, 2014, I started taking it a lot more seriously, but I was a lot more younger in that age. And, I started noticing that I was pretty good at COD. And then around 2016, I definitely started competing a lot more. I was playing more like IW and Modern Warfare Remastered and Black Ops 3. I was playing like game battles and stuff, but I noticed that it wasn't something I was really good at. But it was something I was pretty decent at. I still have the dream and desire to achieve a championship on a video game LAN, which can be amongst any video game, you know, future tells that, you know, could be the next upcoming FPS hit or something. But at the moment, I don't believe it's going to be Call of Duty. But I started streaming whenever I got into my Fortnite days, when I was competing in Fortnite as well. And then I just started slowly love streaming whenever I was playing with my friends. And I'd say one person who definitely inspired me the most, since we had very similar changes on how we liked our things, was Shroud. If you don't know who Shroud is, and you're still in the scene, very surprising, but Shroud was a CSGO professional for a very long time. And once he started getting more into games like Players Unknown Battlegrounds, which is also known as PUBG, and a bunch of other battle royale games, he noticed that it was benefiting him more just making content and being a streamer and than it was him just being a professional player. And being a professional player does take a toll. It's a lot of practice, it's a lot of hard work, and it's a lot of dedication to the game. And I wouldn't say he lost that, but he realized that it just wasn't the route for him. For some people, such as myself, I realized that competitive Call of Duty will always be in my heart. I'll always love playing it or playing games similar like it, but it's very, very hard, you know, finding a team, finding teammates, and just sticking through with it and proceeding to go through. And this also brings up what I want to take into the future. I still have the dream of winning enough LAN. But it doesn't specifically have to be a competitive esports LAN. It can be, you know, like a fun LAN or maybe just friendly competition. I don't know where I will be in my future, but I'm definitely going to see how that goes. And that answers PokemonLover9000's question. On to the next question we have from Fixie. What is your favorite part of being a content creator / streamer? Another really great question. I think mostly all of these questions are really great questions. I would say my favorite part about being a content creator and streamer is meeting and interacting with new people. I meet a lot of people in game, and then they meet my channel and they start following me through my channel and my uprise, hopefully soon. And I like meeting new people in my chat. Recently, I've been streaming for a lower viewer count, which I don't mind doing. And I've been meeting people through that, just looking through small streamers and stuff. And there's also other good streamers who are on my level or maybe a little bit higher or a little bit lower that I like talking to and sharing content and just ideas that I can spread amongst other people. And it's a lot of fun because it's a really positive impact on my mental health, because things that make me happy are making other people happy. So if my content is able to make another person happy, it satisfies me. So that's why I really like being a content creator and streamer, and it drives me more to be more better at what I do. And that answers Fixie's question. The next question goes to Brian LJ. And where do you see yourself in the next 10 years? That. So I'm currently 19 at the moment. So in the next 10 years, I will probably, I will be 29 years old. I hope to see myself pretty driven to my passion, because I would say I do have a passion at the moment, but I'm clearly not really too much of knowing what my passion is. But I really love what I'm doing at the moment, and your passion is usually what you love to do. So I hope that at the time, whatever I love doing, I'm doing it for either full time or still doing it no matter what. And by 29, I hope to at least settle down a bit with someone. Maybe a kid. You never know. You know, I could have a kid, and you know, just the typical life that everybody would like. So, but that's in 10 years. Hopefully, the economy in the U.S. and everything else around the world is pretty good at the same time. So, that would be pretty awesome. And that answers Brian's question. The next question comes from Beware JV, which is one of my best friends. And this is a good question. He says, Apex helped your content and you as a content creator grow with the new COD coming out and Warzone changing up. Do you see yourself moving away from the game? And I believe he talks about moving away from Apex. Honestly, I know eventually that I will grow out of Apex and I will grow out of other games. Because there was always a new game that will be made that will be better than the past games, because everything evolves, you know, everything becomes better. So at the moment, I don't see Apex leaving. I don't see myself leaving Apex anytime soon, mostly because it's consistently growing and this new season is really, really good. But I do see myself trying to balance the Call of Duty content and the Apex content together, just so I can get more of that FPS base around people. So but I don't see myself, I know eventually I will have to leave the game, either one of the games, but not anytime soon. So, and this next question comes from Ubu Dip, which is another one of my good friends. Who is your favorite person to play video games with? So I do have a lot of people I really enjoy playing games with, but I do have not really too much favoritism, but I do have a preferred people I would always like just play games with no matter what game it was. And let's do like a top five, because I love playing with all kinds of people. There are some people I don't like playing with, but it's just for that game. You know, like sometimes in Apex, I like to sweat a lot in Apex. So I like playing with friends who are equal sweats. So when it comes to playing like games like Apex Legends, I like playing with my friend Dark Puma One. He's really good. I would say we're on equal same skill base level. And he's also like one of my best friends in a duo. So I really like playing with him on Apex. On playing Warzone, I would say also Puma, but I also like playing with my friend Jordy TV a lot. He's really good at Warzone. He has really good comms. He has good energy too. So he's pretty good at Warzone. Overall, like funny people and very people I like playing with no matter what game it is. I would say my friend Kat, which is the one who put this question. Her name is Uwu Dip. And also my other friend, Beware JV, which had the previous question. Those guys, those are my best friends. So no matter what, I always love playing with them no matter what game it is. You know, we're always having a good time too. So that answers that question. The next question comes from Jaybo. It says, how do you beam kids like the pros? I'm flattered. Not gonna lie. I'm a little flattered that he says like the pros. But basically short story, I watch a lot of professional players. I don't like watching amateur players. I do like watching amateur players, but I don't study amateur players. I study more pro players. So I like studying how they aim, how they shoot, how they work against in different situations, and what call-offs to take. Because You know, most of these guys are at the top, so they know what they're doing. They know how to do it. And so I wouldn't say I want to be at the top, but I want to be able to perform like someone that close. And far as aim wise, I always try focusing on where my bullets are going or where I'm shooting at, and set up just like center of the screen. But you know, my aim is not the best. My aim's pretty good sometimes, but I, like I said, I focus a lot on where my shots are going, and I study a lot of pro players. So if you guys, I would say if you guys are on keyboard and mouse and you want to get your aim better, don't take any advice from me, mostly because I play a lot on controller. But I would definitely say, you know, there's Kovacs, there is Aim Labs, there's a lot of good people who do coaching, there's coaching lessons, and then even for controller players, like if you just want to learn how to become a better player overall, I would recommend, you know, watching pro players' VODs. You can also do coaching as well. YouTube's really good for a lot of people who need help. Yeah, I would definitely recommend checking out that kind of stuff. And this one comes from Nymphlim. It says, "Who is your favorite hip hop artist of all time?" This is a really tough one, because I do have a lot of people that I like listening to, but I would say music has a lot of impact on my mentality and my work ethic, mostly because I feel comfortable with music and music makes me comfortable with what I do. So I do like exploring a lot of music. I listen to a lot of music. But I would say my definite top five would be Childish Gambino would be my first. He has some of my favorite songs. My second would most likely be Logic. I've been following Logic for a while. He has really good music as well. My third would be, I would say, I'd say my third would also be Kendrick Lamar. Kendrick Lamar, when he dropped Good Kid, Mad City, that album really pushed me towards liking that the genre more of hip hop. So, and I was a lot younger back then, so I started getting more into music because of that album. It also introduced me to a lot of like other rappers and stuff when he started making more come up of a music style. So I did like I do like a lot of Kendrick Lamar. My fourth would be who's a good, oh, the I wouldn't say this is like a specific artist, but the Wu-Tang Clan is definitely one of my favorites, mostly because it's really old school, but they still have like a flow, and their flows are just so executable, and they're really good, and then the rhyming is just perfect, and those guys just killed it whenever they made their music. Method Man, Ghostface Killah, I can just name most of them, and I love the Wu-Tang Clan. And my fifth, I would have to say, I know some people wouldn't agree, but I would have to say Juice WRLD, mostly because Juice WRLD put a lot of emotion into his music, and like a lot of people like myself can definitely connect to most of what he says in his music and just feel it on a spiritual level. And it's like, it's really crazy, because you know, most of the music I listen to, the reason I listen to it is because I feel it like deeply in me, that I can relate to it a lot. But I don't know, I'm a music head, so I just love music, you know, so much. And it's one of the things that I love doing. But yeah, that concludes my first Q&A video going on YouTube here. Like I said, if you made it through the whole video and you want to be in the next one, feel free to drop a question in the comments of this video, and I will definitely consider putting it in the next one. So, but that's about it. If you guys haven't watched any of my other videos, I do have a lot more other videos going up soon. I'll most likely be uploading a video a day after this one. And if you want to check out some those content creators who asked those questions, I'm going to leave all their links in the bio, and I will also leave my social media. Feel free to check out my Twitch. I do stream daily. I stream about a couple hours a day, and mostly on the weekends I try to stream for a lot longer. And then I do post TikToks as well. I have an Instagram page I also post on. But I would say mostly my Twitter is where I'm mostly active, where you get live updates about my content and things like that. And if you guys want to join the CrossFam Discord, I do have a Discord available as well. I have a lot of great announcements also when I'm going live, and just for chatting if you want to chat with other people and stuff like that. But that concludes the video for today. You guys stay safe out there. Wear your mask, be kind to others, love each other, and most of all, love yourself. Peace. Thank you.